Between the time when the oceans drank Atlantis and the rise of the Sons of Arius, there was an age undreamed of. And unto this, Lilac, destined to wear the jeweled crown of Aquilonia upon a troubled brow. It is I, his chronicler, who alone can tell thee of his saga. Let me tell you of the days of high adventure.
Hello and welcome to Conan Exiles. This is a game which came out today in early access on Steam. A game which I've had my eye on for a while because I am a fan of Conan. Not because I am a fan of survival games, which is what this game is. I suck at survival games. I suck at online games. I don't really play them very much. You'll have to bear with me. I don't know anything about this game. I've played it for about 5 minutes to get some test footage. I don't know how it works. If that sounds like something that you wouldn't find fun to watch, please, I won't be offended if you want to close the video down now. Go and watch something else. A lot of people play these kind of games on the internet. They will probably have made better videos on YouTube, better streams on Twitch of this game already. I won't be offended. If you have stuck around after that preamble, welcome! My name is Lilac, welcome to Conan Exiles. So, this is a game pretty much a little bit like Rust or Ark, which are very popular online games. It's not a genre which I'm familiar with. I have played a little bit of both of those, but I don't really know how they work. All I know is that you have to craft things, you have to eat and drink water, you have to survive in a hostile world. In this case, it's the hostile world of Robert E. Howard's Conan the Cimmerian, which is awesome. So we play as a barbarian who's been crucified in the desert. We need to build our character. We will do that fairly quickly. Let's be eeny, meeny, meeny, miny, moe, female. Oh yes, this game has full nudity in it, which I have turned off for the purposes of YouTube. If you are desperate to see that nudity, feel free to go and buy this game. It costs £24.99 or your equivalent in dollars. Or you can probably just find videos of the nudity online. What I will say about it is that it does have, in the character creation, an endowment slider for the male characters, so you can easily slide up and down the size of their dong, which is amazing. Also, the dong itself is affected by physics and has very, very light, unrealistic, weightless dangle physics built in so that the wind actually blows your character's flaccid cock around. It's hilarious and very brilliant. The female characters, unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on your viewpoint, you cannot custom build their vagina, but they do have a big barbarian bush, which is cool. You can change the size of their boobies and stuff. It's all very, 1980s, I guess you could say. if your opinion on that is one of a kind of libertarian, left-wing, modern viewpoint, please, you know, don't let me stop you. I'm all for equality and all that. I just think it's pretty funny. So, without further ado, let us choose our race. We can go Hyborian. I'm not going to take too long with this, by the way. This just basically changes your appearance and your... Oh, you can move the character's head so you can see there. Appearance and, like, deity, I think. Cimmerian, that's like what Conan is. Descendant of the ancient Atlantean. Stygian,
the best. Chew it slow.
Yep, the priests of Set are the true power in the land. So you can see she has Thulsa Doom hair. I'm, to be honest, already going towards that. Tribal Himelian. Hyrcanian or Turanian. Dark and slender. Kitan. I think, isn't Kitan what Subutai is?
I am Subutai, thief and archer.
Kushite, the Black Kingdom. Nordheimer, Aryan. Pict, warring tribe or something. Shemite, nomadic, skill with bows. Darfari, barbaric to the core and savage. Vendian, referred to as the Golden Kingdom, a cast of rulers who are considered close to divinity. Sounds cool. Yep. Oh, Zamora. Sorry, you're going to hear me quoting that film quite a lot in a really stupid way. I do apologise in advance. I can't help myself. It's one of my favourite films. City of Thieves, Zingaren, Seaports and Sailors. Yep, okay, cool. So we'll go for Stygian, the best. Chew it slow. Religion, Set, of course. Two snakes in a standard, joined together, coming together as one, facing each other in combat.
He's coming. The gods are watching. Cut me down. Cut me down, please.
Hey!
Hey! Nice. Oh, it's got to be that one, right? Let's just try more of that. Yeah, that's the one. That's the one. Okay. Head options. Yeah, she looks a little like Thulsa Doom, I guess. Let's just randomize a bit. Oh, that's cool. Kind of Cleopatra looking. Yeah, we'll have that one. And I mean, she's supposed to be... Oh, Thulsa Doom, well, obviously played by a black actor, was kind of like... It almost seemed like James Earl Jones had been lightened up to play the role. I remember seeing in a documentary about that film that they wanted to make him look like otherworldly. So I guess we'll have her kind of that colour. Sort of somewhere between Caucasian and like Middle Eastern. Or we could have her like super pale, which would be good. No, she's weather-beaten. She has to be like this. Okay. Hairstyle. That's... Yeah. Oh, that's quite cool. I do like the one with the step fringe, I have to say, just because it looks like Thulsa Doom. Contemplate this on the Tree of Woe. So... Eyebrows. What we got? Oh, that's not good. That's like Cara Delevingne. I don't like caterpillar eyebrows, by the way. Yeah, thin eyebrows, I guess. She can look a bit groomed. I'm not taking too long with this. Lips. That'll do. I don't really want any lipstick or anything. It doesn't seem to make much difference. Just have skin-coloured lips. Eyeshadow. Heavy eyeshadow, I like that. Face details. We can customise things, as you can see. Not too worried about this right now, but... cheek width. Of course I could spend ages doing this, but high cheekbones, I guess. Yep. Nose width, narrow, scale. Slightly protuberant, I think. And quite high up. Mouth thickness. Oh, that's quite a cool feature. Let's have her quite pursed. Ears. Angle and shape. Can't really see them. Doesn't matter. Eyes. Ugh. Think they were alright as they were. downward facing. Make her look a bit mean. Spacing. Quite close. No, medium set. Black eyes, or we could have like grey eyes would be quite cool. No, I want dark green eyes. That's what I want. That's one for the followers of Set, the snake god. Should have her quite tall? Just above medium height. physique, so you can see, yeah, breast size. I'm not particularly bothered about breast size, but this is one of those games where you can look down in first person and see your character's body. So if you have the breasts all the way up, then you basically, like, can't see anything when you look down apart from giant boobs, which is like that classic game Jurassic Park Trespasser, which is seen as one of the worst PC games ever made. You have no partial or full nudity. Partial is breasts exposed. Full nudity is fully naked. We're just obviously going to go for no nudity. I'm not bothered about nudity. We will call her Jurelle after Jurelle of Jouarre, which is another Weird Tales fantasy character from the 1930s. If you get that ref, you are awesome. Here hangs Jurelle the Stygian, condemned to death and exile for crimes including impersonating a priestess, crude language, inciting a riot. Any who remove this body, living or dead, from the cross will be flayed alive along with all members of their family. Much I remember, but much I have forgotten. I have been in a far land across misty voids and gulfs and unlit oceans. During the year of the Cobra, a prisoner captured by unknown means was transported into the exiled lands, crucified and left to die for crimes they may or may not have committed. Death comes swiftly on black wings, until fate intervenes.
This land does not love men. Shall I cut you down? It might kill you.
So the character is saved by Conan. For some reason, Conan is travelling these exiled lands and decides to cut us down from our cross. We then start the game, and as you can see, we have third-person options as well as first-person. And they, as you can see what I was meaning about the boobs, that's why I went for small boobs, because it means we can actually see our character's body. Graphics are really nice, running on Unreal 4. Looking pretty damn good overall. This is like some vast expanse of horrible, blighted desert. You can see the stats at the top are what I will be no good at in this game. It's like survival, has survival stats. The best way I can describe it to anyone who doesn't know this, what this type of game is like a more complex version of the survival mode in Minecraft. We can take rocks, we can harvest plant fiber, seeds, handful of insects. As you can see, I am taking a lot of stuff down here. We have to be getting things like plant fiber so we can craft ourselves some clothing. We have to get sticks and stones so we can craft weapons and tools. I have already leveled up, as you can see. The reason for that... Oh, a flask. What does this say?
I am beaten, left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here, slaves, bandits and cannibals. Exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me. The sun of the glittering spires of Belvarus is forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence, and this cursed land will finally end me. Whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
Okay, cool. Voice acting's actually all right, you know? Like, I think this is some sort of, like, lore tablet or something divine that we can use.
Behold, Pundit One, the very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, by the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
To the city, you say? Sounds good. So, we have an inventory screen. We can craft things just like in Minecraft. You can see here. Ooh, Sepulchre of Set. Sounds fucking ace. Okay. We need to get ourselves some clothes, I suppose. 25 plant fibers required for that. Now you see it is added to the crafting queue. It will take a while to craft, but hand wraps and things as well. Foot wraps. We'll add all these things, and then we need a stone pick so we can mine stones. That's going to take 5 branches and 5 stones to make. We don't have any branches yet, so we can't do that, but we'll have some clothes. Plant fiber and branches. Yeah, so we need branches to craft tools like torches and stuff. You can see the stats draining at the top. That is hunger, thirst, that kind of thing. We have HP as well. I have actually altered a few multipliers for these stats, so because I'm so shitty at these games, at that I have decided to make it a little easier on myself. I can go a bit longer without finding food and water, and I deal very slightly more damage to enemies, that kind of thing. I've not made it like easy mode or anything, but I'm expecting to die a lot. I don't actually even really know how much I'm planning to play of this game on my channel. I just wanted to check it out because I'm a huge fan of Conan. So, the other thing is that I'm playing this in single player, at least for now, because this is a multiplayer game primarily where you are, it's designed, ooh, a branch, yeah, we need a lot of these, it's designed for you to, basically play in a world with a lot of other people, build bases and fortify those bases, build an army, and then sabotage other people's shit and, like, take them out in the brutal style of Conan. Uh-oh. Okay, good, it was just a showpiece. Don't fancy fighting something like that right now. So, I'm going to carry on picking things up and making my way down this path. Hopefully we will find something quite soon, and I will get my... Yeah, got some clothes coming in the crafting queue. You can also turn up multipliers so things craft a lot faster, but I didn't do that. I want it to be at least somewhat of a survival experience. Did I get a water flask? Sealed water skin. Yes, I did. And I've leveled up, so... we have 2 points to spend. Let's take 1 in survival, 1 in strength for now, I think. Learn recipes. Oh, okay. So we have more armor and weapons. Brute 3. Stone club. Stone maul. Stone sword. That could be good. Sword! You took my father's sword! Can I have my shirt now? It's nearly ready. Come on. Hey! And it auto-equipped. Right, we have another point to spend, apparently. We level up again. Let's take another survival. I'm feeling very paranoid about the survival aspect of this game, so I think we will go for that. At least for now. This actually does look like it's going to be a lot of fun. Now, bearing in mind that there is... This game is... Okay, that's rock we can harvest. Gotcha. So, let's see. Can we make a stone pick? Yes, we can. But would a torch be better because of nighttime? No, let's craft one of these. We'll add it to the queue at least. So... I'm keeping an eye on my thirst gauge so that I can drink my water flask when I need it. Ah, and here we have some vegetation, which is looking good because it means we should be able to find some water to drink around here soon, I'm hoping. There's a big statue of something just over there, which may be worth investigating. There's also a lot of sticks, which is good because I need sticks. So as I was just about to say, right, there are quite a lot of games like and unlike this on Steam. Oh dear. Oh dearie me. Okay. Stay calm. Stay calm. It's a little Grummite fella. He actually looks like... Ow. You hit really fucking hard, sir. Okay, he's dead. I'm nearly dead. He didn't have anything. How do I get health back? That was really bad. Boob wobble physics. They still haven't been able to get boob jiggle physics right in video games. But that's not egregiously offensive like Dead or Alive or something. Okay, my health does seem to be regenerating somewhat, which is good. I am nearly out of water, though. I do need to take this. Use. Okay, so we get 3 uses out of it, and it seems to fill our thirst gauge by around about half each time we do. So, interesting. Give me all the sticks. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but little Grummite fellas will hit really fucking hard. Oh dear, what the fuck is that? Okay, can we sneak? Yes, we can sneak. Yes, this is good. Yes, we need to sneak. Sneaky does it. Oh, there's water. Can I refill the flask, or is it just 3 uses and then it's destroyed? And can I craft more of the flasks? I have my hand wraps now, as you can see. The leg wraps, or whatever they are, trousers are coming on. Yeah, leggings, and then we've got foot wraps, then we've got a pick. Can I learn to make a stone sword, please? Level 3, cost 1. Requires that. Okay, right, got you. We can make a hatchet and a bedroll. Bedroll, I believe, is like works like a bed in Minecraft, so you can do that. Unlock that. We have available 1. Can we get this now? Yeah, cool. So we now should have more recipes. Yes, we do. Let's add... What do we need? Twine. How do we make twine? With plant fiber. So we'll craft some twine. Let's get 2 of them going. And then... We can make a stone sword. Oh, hang on. How many do we get with twine? So we need... Wait. We need 10... Jesus Christ, do we only get 1 for each use? Oh no, it's 3. So we need 3, 6, 9, 12. There we go, that should be enough. Now we have to wait a long time. What fun. Well, I should be able to explore and get... Oh, we need to eat as well. Right, how do I get food? Can I kill this deer? Can I punch it to death or will it run away? Hey, buddy. Die! Oh dear! No, it's one of these. Can I eat these? I want to eat. Let me eat. Okay, what does this do? Open, cancel, loot all. Open? Oh, okay, I see. Well, I'm kind of thinking... I have my trousers. I'm kind of thinking, can I make a bed? I need twine for a bed. I'm going to have to put that. Right. The twine's going to have to come up the queue. So we can make a bed to respawn in when we inevitably die of starvation. Twine. How many do we need for a bed? 3. We have the rest. So. Oh, that can be crafted really quick. So now I can make a bed. No, we just have 1. Okay, so we need 2 more. and then a bed. Then I'm going to just quickly, before I die of starvation or thirst, I'm going to find... Hey, it's you again. Come back. Come back. I want to kill and eat you. Come back. Oh god, there's another Grammite. I don't know what this fella's actually called, but I'm calling them Grammites because they look like Grammites from Oblivion. Oh, don't hurt me. Please don't kill me. I'm nice. I'm also covered in blood. That's cool. Well, this place looks extremely hostile and horrible, but I'm going to go down towards the water that I saw over here, which I think was over here, and I'm going to see if I can find a good place to... Okay, this looks like a nice little place to maybe put a bed. Oh, I'm getting really thirsty and hungry. Right, can we make a bed now? Craft the bed. Make it quick. Okay, it's not that bad. Should be able to do this. We'll drink some more water. And we'll level up again. Awesome. Vitality. We'll learn a recipe later. So. Give me a bed. Oh god! Get punched. Get punched out. Do you have anything? No, these guys don't have anything to give me. Well, they've certainly got the brutality right, bearing in mind that I've actually tailored this to be quite easy for myself. So, we can probably go and drink from that river, I imagine. We now have a bed. Let's pop the bed here. Interact, dismantle, cancel. Interact. Spawn point up. Dated. Spawn point updated. So when I inevitably die of hunger right now, I can respawn there. But I think it means I will drop my equipment. So we don't want to go too far from it. Can I get some fish or something? Hello? Oh, okay. Just a little bit of glitchiness there. I can see fish. Can I grab them and eat them? Are these fish? Yeah, they are. Can I kill you, please? Can I grab you? Like in Subnautica or Skyrim? No. I need air. Air. Where? Right. What do I eat? How can I eat? Can I get something to eat with? A fork? Can I craft a fork and then stab them with that? Can I eat plants? Right. What was that? I heard something. I heard a beast. A horrible beast. Oh man, I'm scared. Can I eat the plant fibers? Oh god! Ah, it's just a Grammite. Okay, these guys aren't too bad now. I've leveled up a few times. But it would be really nice if I could eat them. Can I eat plants? Ah! Where are they all coming from? I'm nearly dead. I'm almost, in fact, almost entirely dead. Oh god. Right. Fair enough. So, there's a little baby turtle fella there. Can I kill the babies and eat them? Oh god. I'm dead. And I dropped my stuff. That's an option you can turn off, by the way, to drop your stuff. But if I can... Yeah. Well, I respawn at my bed, which apparently has now been destroyed. So... Oh, God. Well, I now have nothing. Let's go around picking up rocks again. Okay, so... Nah. I see you. Combat's fairly rudimentary, but it works pretty well. I mean, it's it's not especially worse than an Elder Scrolls game or something. So that's you know, some mark of quality, I suppose. God damn you! Well, okay. Terrific. So where do we respawn now, considering that we don't have a bed? I really need to get one of those gazelles. Oh. Okay. We respawn all the way back here then. Well, that's fine. So, you know what? I'm going to end this episode here. I am going to do some more of this. I'm not sure how much. But I will probably do a little bit off camera, maybe collect some things, see if I can work out how this game actually works before I record the next one. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video of Conan Exiles. If you did, let me know what you think. Drop me a like, and I will see you next time for more of it. Take care and goodbye.